The Soldier's Guide to PTSD, A No-Shit Guide to Reclaiming Your Life, by Virginia Cruse, narrated by Kelli. Introduction. Dear Soldier, so we don't know each other. I only know that you have chosen this audiobook, and for the moment, you're listening to it. I appreciate that. Talking about PTSD is my thing. After my third deployment, I was definitely not okay, and nobody knew how to help me. My chain of command, my doctors, my family, or me. I worked hard to get better, and I made lots of mistakes along the way. Eventually, I got my master's degree in mental health counseling, and I started teaching troops. I am convinced that when we know the no-shit facts about PTSD, we make more informed choices and get better faster. I am going to read this book directly to you, as if you were sitting in my class. My classes can feel uncomfortable. PTSD is an unpleasant topic, and people don't like to talk about it. I get that. But that's not good for us. Your life is at stake, my friend, and I'm not going to fuck around. I intend to be as straightforward as I know how to, because I know that PTSD can kill you. We're going to talk about suicide, war crimes, depression, relationships, and more. See, I'm one of those therapists who came to the profession later in life, and I'm not here to waste time. I'm going to teach you everything I wish I knew when I started my own journey, and while you're not going to like it, it's what you probably need to hear. I know PTSD is an ass kicker, and I realize you may not be up to listening to an audiobook, but maybe you could try this one. I'll keep it short. Another reason I recorded this book is that many service members know they have PTSD, but don't know what to do about it. Maybe we believe lies like PTSD never goes away and continue to feel hopeless. This audiobook might find its way into the hands of someone who never knew help was there, and it may show them where to find it. One last thing. I swear. I want to say that up front because a lot of folks are uncomfortable with coarse language. That's completely okay, and I respect it. This is not the right audiobook for you. I don't swear because I'm trying to be cool or provocative, and I'm not trying to hurt your feelings or make you feel sad on the inside. Not swearing is inauthentic for me, and because nothing less than your life is at stake, I won't apologize for what I have to say. There are a lot of great guides out there for civilians and clinicians, but this audiobook is for service members. It's from one soldier to another, from me to you. Because if someone had given me this audiobook back in 2005, it would have saved me years of bullshit. Yours sincerely, Virginia Cruz. Chapter 1. PTSD. What it is and what it's not. Rumors that are absolutely not true and just fuck with your head. There is a lot of information out there about PTSD, but it's not very user-friendly. It is written by clinicians, for clinicians, using psychobabble that doesn't really help anyone. That's why the rumor mill about PTSD is so powerful. Before getting into the down and dirty facts on PTSD, it's important that we discuss what PTSD is not right off the bat. Why? Because knowing is half the battle. These untruths will fuck with your head and keep you from getting the treatment you deserve. The skinny. Post means after. Trauma is exposure to death, serious injury, or sexual violence. Trauma happens to you. It's not something wrong with you. Stress is your body's psychological and physical reaction to danger. Disorder is a clinical word that means your symptoms are getting in the way of your walking, talking, everyday life. That's all. It doesn't mean you're foobar. I compiled this list of untruths, one, from folks with PTSD, and two, from actual master's and doctoral level clinicians whose job is to treat service members with PTSD. So, if you heard one of these and believed it was true, you're in good company. Rumor one, PTSD has no cure. Add to this, I'll always have PTSD, I'll never get better, and the symptoms may go away, but the PTSD will always be there. These are powerful beliefs so widely held that many folks give up before getting started. There are three evidence-based treatments, EBTs, for PTSD that are approved by the VA. Prolonged exposure therapy, cognitive processing therapy, eye movement desensitization and reprocessing therapy. They've all been proven to work for most people, and we are going to go into them in depth in Chapter 5. Using an EBT for PTSD is important because EBTs are based on peer-reviewed scientific evidence. Researchers conduct rigorous studies using scientific methods, document their research in peer-reviewed scientific journals, and then other researchers conduct additional scientific studies to see if the treatment is, in fact, successful. It's a lot like how drugs are tested by the FDA. Double-blind, randomized trials over a very long period of time with lots of scrutiny. When a therapy method is recognized as an EBT, it's a big deal. There are folks who are labeled as treatment-resistant, meaning that these three types of EBTs haven't worked for them, but researchers have found alternative treatments for them, like the use of ketamine, MDMA-assisted psychotherapy, and faith-based treatments. Tons of money has been thrown at PTSD research, and it's paying off in spades. Shout out to researchers and clinicians at the University of Texas Health Science Center's Strong Star Initiative in San Antonio, Texas. They are on the cutting edge of this work. Salient anecdote. A few years back, I worked on a clinical team that served treatment-resistant clients. There was an active-duty female client, late 30s, who had tried all three different evidence-based treatments for PTSD, but was still highly suicidal and depressed. Her PTSD was truly debilitating, and she was getting med-boarded, against her wishes. Her medical chart didn't make sense to me. She was highly intelligent, and she worked harder than her peers. Still, her symptoms never reduced to the point where she could function. I asked her what you will come to know as the big two questions. I asked, do you believe it's possible that you can get help for your PTSD and recover to the point where you'll be able to function better? She calmly and clearly responded, no, I know that's not possible. I asked her why she believed this, and she explained to me that after she was first diagnosed by her psychiatrist on base, the psychiatrist told her that there is no cure for PTSD. She explained, I know that treatment may help me a little, but eventually, I'll just end up killing myself. I'm pretty sure I shat myself. We talked for a long time about PTSD, focusing on the facts and rumors, and then she engaged in treatment with this new knowledge. 4 weeks later, her symptoms reduced to the point where she could function again, and her life was never the same. The bottom line is that EBTs work most of the time for most people. It doesn't matter how you feel, that's science. But hear this, nothing and no one can convince you something is true if you very strongly believe it is not. That's science too. Rumor two, PTSD is only for military.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.